August is hot, and so are the savings at Appalachian Wireless, where all smartphones are 50% off, even the 64, 128, and 256 gig models. Two-year agreement required. Better service, bigger savings. That's today's Appalachian Wireless and East Kentucky Network Company.
So you have a deer in your yard? All right, just stay away from the deer. We'll have someone en route, okay?
In the past couple of weeks, this has become a call the Pikeville Police Department receives on a daily basis due to a significant outbreak of a disease called epizootic hemorrhagic disease, or EHD.
You know, I know we're at least taking one a day. We've took one this morning. We took one yesterday. We took one the day before. So sometimes it's up to three a day. It's just according to people see them and find them.
There are sporadic cases of EHD killing white-tailed deer reported every year, and normally Kentucky Department of Fish and Wildlife officers respond. But with the severity of this year's outbreak in eastern Kentucky, multiple agencies are pitching in to help field the calls.
But if we had to call them on everyone we had, we'd keep them up 24 hours a day. You know, we're having them in the night, we're having them in the evening, we're having them in the early mornings, having them in the middle of the day.
Fish and wildlife officials in Frankfort say blood tests from infected deer in eastern Kentucky have now confirmed what was until recently suspicions of an EHD outbreak. But they stress the disease is not transferable to humans or pets and only infects a deer when it is bitten by a midge fly carrying the disease. So until conditions change and the outbreak comes to an end, Captain Edmonds says his department will do all they can to help.
We have a great partnership with the Department of Fish and Wildlife. They help us, we help them. You know, we need to do our part here, and we're going to. If people in the city limits have problems with a white-tailed deer in their yard that's sick or having problems, contact us. We will make sure they get notified of it.
And that notification is important to fish and wildlife officials who are trying to track all the EHD cases they can.
We are collecting data from that and putting GPS points that way that the wildlife staff can take a look at it on a map and pinpoint exactly where our greatest area is being hit.
The last significant EHD outbreak to affect Pike and surrounding counties was in the fall of 2007. Reporting from Pikeville, I'm Shannon Deskins for EKB News.